season. He really has done an outstanding job, and he'll have to be on his toes tonight.
His counterpart at Illinois State is Bob Donwell, and all he has done is taken the Redbirds to three straight NCAA tournaments.
Well, he too has been at Illinois State for 8 years. He's had his basketball team in a national invitational tournament. He's had his basketball team the last 3 years, Wayne, in the NCAA tournament. That certainly speaks for itself. And in 1984, Bob Donwell was the Missouri Valley Conference Coach of the Year. His teams are characterized by tough, physical, man-to-man defense and a ball-sharing offense.
All right, now Bradley won the two regular season meetings, but in the first meeting they were pressed to overtime in Peoria by the Redbirds. Now let's go to Joe Mills, our public address announcer, for the starting lineups for tonight's game.
We welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to the Missouri Valley Conference postseason tournament. Tonight's semifinal game features the Redbirds of Illinois State against the Bradley Braves. And now, let's meet the starters for tonight's game. At forward for Illinois State, a 6'5 sophomore from Beacon, Illinois, number 34, Matt Taphorn. At forward for Bradley, a 6'7 sophomore from Havana, Illinois, number 40, Trevor Kimby. At forward for Illinois State, a 6'6 junior from Chicago, number 35, Derek Sanders. At the other forward spot for Bradley, a 6'8 sophomore from Nowata, Oklahoma, number 24, Donald Powell. At center for Illinois State, a 7-foot junior from Flanagan, Illinois, number 54, Bill Bratzik. At center for Bradley, a 6'8 senior from Chicago, number 3, Mike Williams. At guard for Illinois State, a 6'4 sophomore from Indianapolis, number 23, Jeff Harris. At a guard spot for Bradley, a 6'3 sophomore from Chicago, number 33, Percy Hawkins. At the other guard spot for Illinois State, a 6'3 freshman from Fort Wayne, Indiana, number 33, Todd Starks. At a guard for Bradley, a 5'11 senior from Niles, Illinois, number 15, Jim West. Tonight's coaches, in his eighth season at Illinois State, Bob Donowall. Also in his eighth season at Bradley, Dick Fisker.
His first personal foul. We see that move by Hersey Hawkins on the baseline. Watch Derek Sanders come over. 35, you see him there. He didn't get there in plenty of time. He was set. Illinois State breaks it across. Taphorn in the lane. Has the ball knocked away. Last touch by the Bradley Braves. It'll belong to Illinois State. Just a great effort by Hersey Hawkins trying to save it, but the ball was already out of bounds, Wayne.
And apparently it was. And Bradley gets it back. Bradley ranked ninth by both polls, AP and UPI.
We don't have to worry about the defense that Illinois State will play. We know it'll be man-to-man. And we know that fundamentally it will be sound, just as we saw in the last series when Taphorn.
Less bumping with Harris, and the foul goes against Bradley's Jimmy Less. His first personal second on the team, Jeff Harris. Threw that foul. 6'4 sophomore from Indianapolis, Indiana.
Wayne, we're obviously going to see the officials take charge of this game very, very early. They're not going to sit on that whistle. They're going to blow it.
Taphorn from the foul line. Sanders had position on the rebound, and Mike Williams has whistled for his first foul. Third on the team. Non-shooting affair.
Well, you've got Hawkins, Less, and Williams with one foul, and we have not played a minute.
Yeah, we're not even a minute into this one.
I'm going to tell you, that's going to be a factor before this thing's over.
Harris trying to get it in and just does in time. This is Matt Taphorn.
Bradley in the zone. It's a matchup zone. They like the trap on the wing.
Sanders baseline off the mark. Taphorn is there, and he flashes it for two. First 2 points of the game. Illinois State out of the gate.
Bradley sets up offensively, and right away, away from the ball, we've got a foul. This one called on Derek Sanders. Called by
by the official on the far side of the court. There is Dick Versace.
Rich Eichhorst
made the call.
What the officials are doing is making sure that they establish the fact that they are present and accounted for. They're going to be in charge of the basketball game. They're aware of the great rivalry that exists. They know that the Illinois State man-to-man defense is physical in nature, and they're not going to let the game get out of control.
63 fouls in that Illinois State 78-70 win over Wichita in the first round. Trippy off the mark. Rex expects a rebound. Sanders comes up with it. Derek Sanders on the dribble now. Sanders finds Harris in the corner. He takes it from deep. And that's it. 4-0 in Illinois State.
You're going to have to get to Harris wherever he is on the floor. The young man's an excellent outside shooter.
6 of 9 from the field yesterday. 19 points in the victory over Wichita State. We've got a foul coming up right here. Todd Starks picks up his first personal foul. That is the second on the team. Trevor Trippy will trigger on the inbound. Todd Starks, the young freshman from Fort Wayne, Indiana. Bothered by the flu this week, not at 100%. Bradley plays on offense. They trail 4-0. Almost 2 minutes in this first half of play. Mike Williams down low, and a crowd was hammered. He was sandwiched down the play. Braxick, along with a teammate, did a job on him.
Williams really used his body, his strength, and his weight effectively that time. He really leaned in. We see a really fine pass inside to Williams right there. He took a one-bounce dribble. You might want to think about that. You can see the foul committed by 35, Derek Sanders, right there. You want to be careful putting the ball on the floor in close quarters, especially against Illinois State, because they collapse so well around the basketball.
Second foul on Sanders, third on the team. Could have gone either way. Braxick also hammered Williams. Tell you what, it takes two guys to hammer Mike Williams. He's a big man.
Well, he's experienced both ends of the spectrum. He has a season high of 30 points, a season low of 3 points.
Williams, with his second upcoming, has played very well off the boards in Missouri Valley competition.
And we get a little full court pressure after the made free throw by the Bradley Braves.
Illinois State breaks it across. Harris freed up for the pops. Williams has the rebound. Bradley Braves could tie the ball game with a field goal right here.
He definitely had a good shot, but he was not in good rhythm when he took it.
Jim West with the stutter step dribble, and Williams on the slam. No! It will not count. Offensive basket interference.
That's a good call. You cannot be in the cylinder. You cannot touch the basketball if it's in the cylinder. It's laying up on top. That's a great effort by Mike Williams, a tremendous effort, and a very impressive play, but an illegal one.
Illinois State still leads it by 2. Early going first half from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Semifinal action to the Missouri Valley postseason basketball tournament. Todd Starks clears it over to Jeff Harris, and Harris is called for the traveling violation. His second turnover by Illinois State.
Harris got in a hurry. He made a good move, but he pulled that foot, pivot foot.
Bradley again could tie with a field goal right here. Braves only the second Missouri Valley team with a perfect conference seasonal record. Powell lost the handle on it. Trippy trying to save, and as he saves, he steps out of play. Ball hit the baseline. Illinois State retains possession. Second turnover for Bradley.
Taphorn working very hard defensively against Percy Hawkins, and that's a key matchup. You can shut Hawkins down just a little bit. You affect his Bradley team, I promise.
There starts at the baseline. Rebound battery taken by Trippy. Trevor Trippy, who does a little bit of everything for the Bradley Braves. Now Jimmy Left went over Braxick with that shot and came up short. Sanders takes off the floor. Illinois State leading it by 2. Almost 3.5 minutes into this first half of play. Jeff Harris. There's Taphorn. Sanders in the lane. Taphorn from deep. Williams clears the board in heavy traffic for the Bradley Braves, and Jim West pushes it up. Here's the backdoor feed to Powell, and he's bumped on the play, but they're going to go against Powell with the foul. Bumped with Derek Sanders. Watch it again.
You see the alley-oop pass to Donald Powell. Derek Sanders is there. They called Powell for being over Sanders' back. Pretty good idea. Not a bad idea. They've been playing that way. We look at the foul situation. 4-3 right there.
Powell hit with his first personal foul. No question, Sanders had room. He had the position on that play. Harris, you've got to respect what he did yesterday at 19 points.
offensive basketball player.
Down low, Sanders rolling to the hoop. Nicely done. Illinois State leading it by four. 15:48 left to go. First half. Bradley's only scored 2 points.
Off to a slow start. The pace of the game is just a little bit quicker than I thought Illinois State might want it. Dwayne, I expected Bradley to prefer that up tempo a little bit.
Brother 20 from the outside. His first field goal of the ball game. He has two.
Big basket by Trimpey. Everybody contributes on this Bradley team. Illinois State 3 out of 9 in field goal shooting. Bradley 1 out of 4.
Eric Sanders baseline. Will go. Rebound. Braxic for two. Big Bill Braxic inside. Again, the lead is 4. Trimpey holds up for Bradley. This is Jimmy West. Outside, Trimpey again from deep. Williams trying to corral the rebound and does. Now Williams goes to the hoop. Offensive foul. He leaned in, and that's his second personal foul on Mike Williams. Technical foul called on Mike Williams. Nick Forsay's walking down the sideline to the scorer's table.
We see Williams inside. He does charge here. He really is bringing the ball strong to the basket. He had a good shot. He should have been able to rise right there and shoot it off the glass. He reacted to what he thought was a bad call. Ron Zetcher responded immediately with a technical foul. Dick Versace in conversation, deep conversation with Ron Zetcher, not happy about the call.
Jeff Harris at the free throw line now for Illinois State converts. Illinois State now leading it by 5, 14:59 left to be played, and the conversation continues between Zetcher, Versace, and now Bob Donwald, an interested observer.
That's a pretty good shot right there.
We'll be back after these local messages.
People drive from all over central Illinois to Sam Lehman Chevy Olds Pontiac in Eureka.
We shopped around and we called Lehman's and they said they could beat any deal and they did.
They buy new cars.
I like the service.
Generous trade-in allowance.
They buy used cars.
Honest place.
I like the friendly staff.
And they just keep coming back.
I would buy my next car there.
Sam Lehman Chevrolet. It's worth the trip.
It is worth the trip to Sam Lehman Chevy Olds Pontiac in Eureka.
Sam finds life to be a taxing experience. He doesn't know about Tallman Home. Melissa thinks life is an adventure. She shelters her money in a Tallman Home IRA and earns tax-deferred interest while it's growing. Diane doesn't worry about reality, but her father knew she had a hard time being practical, so he left her money in Tallman Home CDs. Ross knows good investments. He invests in a Tallman Home annuity and a Tallman IRA. He wants to live well, so he goes to the leader in tax-advantaged products. Life doesn't have to be taxing.
Methodist has certainly grown a lot since our beginning in 1900. Today, we're a major medical center, bringing the latest technology to central Illinois, like the new SPECT scanner to help your doctor pinpoint problems and make diagnosis without the risk and expense of exploratory surgery. Advanced, efficient technology, from CT to linear accelerators, helping us to hold the line on hospital costs and continuing our tradition of care for you.
Some very strong words between Coach Versace and Ron Zetcher. And I do not mean unkind words, but some strong words. We'll see what impact that might have on this ballgame.
Taphorn connects, and the impact he has had now is that Illinois State is on top by 7. 14:36 to go, first half of play. Illinois State playing very well here in the early going. Oh, good feed on the backside to Williams.
Well, that's an excellent shot by Donald Powell. He picked up the open man immediately, and let me tell you, Williams is playing with authority. He just needs to be careful that he keeps himself out of foul trouble.
2-on-1, Sanders swings over Williams. Tell you what, the Redbirds aren't intimidated.
Oh, not at all. They're very well prepared, and keep in mind, Bob Donawald values preparation tremendously.
Jimmy Less out at the point now, running the offense for the Bradley Braves. Less trying to force the pass into Williams, and it's picked on the play by Todd Starks. Starks, as I mentioned, the young freshman team leader in steals. There's Bob Donawald on the Illinois State bench. All Missouri Valley Conference freshman selection.
He'll be one of the outstanding guards in this league for many years to come. Trevor Clifton feeding Williams down low, and Williams has two balls. Boy, they've done such a great job down the stretch this season and getting the ball inside of Mike Williams. He has 6 points now this game. 5-point lead, Illinois State. In the corner, we've got a foul on Braxick away from the ball.
Well, I tell you, Harris drained that one from the corner, too, and he really is shooting the basketball well.
But Braxick, as he tried to set the pick, was guilty of the foul, his first, fourth on the team.
It was an illegal block. Harris playing with a lot of confidence. 6 turnovers for Bradley Braves already. 3 for Illinois State.
One of the reasons why Illinois State leads it by 5. As Bradley resumes, Les has a set play for the Braves.
I mention it one more time. Taphorn doing a great defensive job.
Taphorn that time did not have position, and he's called for the foul. His first, the fifth on the team. And watch it again, Coach.
He's a help side defensive player. That right there, that responsibility is a secondary defensive responsibility. His primary responsibility in this game is Hersey Hawkins. Here's that interior feed. You see 34, Taphorn move over. Didn't get set, made contact. Williams will go to the free throw line.
2-2 at the charity stripe here tonight. 6 points for Mike Williams. Senior center out of Chicago, Illinois. All he can do now is cut it down to 4. Gary Thomas comes on. He has missed much of the last 2 weeks. Thomas replacing Powell. He's missed much of the last 2 weeks with an ankle injury. Gary Thomas set to go.
We'll see how he responds to game action with that bad ankle.
Williams connects on the second. 1 out of 2 at the line for Mike Williams, and the lead is 4 for Illinois State. Bradley continues to extend the defense. Redbirds break it across. Jeff Harris. Todd Starks. Good move by Starks. Taphorn feeding down low. Derek Sanders has had many opportunities inside, and more often than not, he has converted. Les right back with it to Hawkins. Hawkins had it blocked, but he was fouled. Taphorn gets the call. Second personal on Matt Taphorn, and he expresses his frustration. 16 fouls now in Illinois State. We've still got 12:51 left to go first half.
We see Hawkins here. He beats Taphorn on the baseline. There is a foul committed. I'm not sure it was against Taphorn, though. He got a piece of the basketball. Taphorn doing a good defensive job on Hawkins, as I mentioned. I don't know whether this can be picked up by our viewers, but the intensity on the part of the players, the concentration, you can see it in their eyes. And, I mean, it's just tremendous, and you really like to see that. You would expect that you would have it in the semifinals of the postseason tournament to determine who goes to the NCAA tournament, and believe me, it does prevail here tonight.
Even more than that, the fact that this is such a great rivalry back in Central Illinois, and you can't understate that, you can't overstate that enough.
Well, I spent a lot of time in Central Illinois, and believe me, junior high school basketball, college basketball in Central Illinois, second to none.
5-point lead for the Redbirds as they resume offensively. 12:40 left to go, first half of play. Sanders again. Thomas right there for the rebound. Jim West now moves it across in a hurry for the Bradley Braves. Trevor Trimpey wants to go down low and does to Williams. They kick it right back outside of Trimpey.
They are really concentrating on the inside game.
Hawkins feeding Williams. He has to chase it down. Now Trimpey resets the offense. Jimmy left. Trimpey from deep. Sanders, the lone Redbird in a crowd. Hawkins comes away and misses the shot, and he took a terrible fall. The officials are going to stop the action right now because Hawkins came down and hit the back of his head on the floor.
Well, my goodness. Let's hope he's okay. It's physical inside. It's tough in there. I think Williams is fortunate he got away with not being called for a foul right there. It's Hersey Hawkins.
Went over the back of Matt Taphorn. You can't see the way he hit his head, but boy, from our vantage point, you can see it. My goodness.
Not only his head, but I think his lower back. I think he landed on his... Yes, he did. It was his
lower back.
Yeah,
lower back. Yep.
That concerns me even more than the back of his head. His head really did not hit the floor, but he hasn't moved very much.
His head may have hit the floor after the initial impact of the lower back, but again,
I really think that the job that Illinois State is doing against Percy Hawkins.
Well, you know, West Texas State had Hawkins out of the ballgame for a period in that first half the other day. Once Bradley got Hawkins back into the game and switched to a man-to-man defense, that's when they really began to make their move against the Bucs.
You are exactly right. Coach Versace continues conversation with Ron Zetcher, but believe me, that is a very good point. We talked about it several times yesterday, and to this point, offensively, Hersey has not made his presence felt in the ballgame. The thing about the young man is he's such an outstanding player. He will continue to do what he has to do in terms of making the effort, and as long as you're doing that performance, he'll take care of himself. They had to take him out of the game so that they are not charged with a timeout. Coach Versace very wisely would not want to be charged with a timeout. Bertolini is in his place.
Illinois State, Redbirds have made it to the semifinals of the MVC tournament. Several occasions in the past, at least 3 years that I can remember in our 5 years of doing the game. There's Derek Sanders from the corner. Derek Sanders having an outstanding first half. He's got 8 points already. We're not even halfway through the initial stanza.
He's really shooting the ball well.
Mike Williams down low over Braxton. Sanders right there for the rebound. Redbirds are crashing the boards hard. This is Matt Taphorn, and he'll be called for step. 4 turnovers now for Illinois State. Donald Powell, number 24, back into the lineup for the Bradley Braves. Got a look at the turnover situation. Bradley with 6. That's what they averaged for the year. Trevor Trippi on the wing, leading interior to Thomas baseline. Powell going for the rebound, and Jimmy Less also. We got a foul coming up. I believe it's going to be on Todd Starks for pushing off. Starks of Illinois State. His second, that's the 7th on the team, so the Redbirds are overlooked. 1-1 opportunity coming up for the Bradley Braves.
And as we expected, we thought we would see some free throw shooting tonight. Illinois State does commit more fouls, I'm sure, than Bob Donowald wants them to commit. Bradley already in the 1-1 with 11 minutes and 19 seconds on the clock. And here comes the guy that determined the outcome of the game yesterday, Wayne.
William Anderson came off the bench yesterday, the only senior on the Illinois State Redbird squad, and he scored 30 points, hit 16 of 17 free throws. I thought that was a lost effort in college basketball.
Well, I tell you, he just had a great basketball game, and he is fundamentally a good shooter day in and day out.
He struggled this year early in the season, Bob, and really it was the second half of the season that he came out and put his game together down the stretch. 2 points now for Jimmy Less as he drains a pair at the line. The lead is 5 for Illinois State. 11:15 left to go, first half of play.
Taphorn continues to play the point against the Bradley zone. The purpose of that is because he can swing the ball a little easier with the additional size.
Sanders in the lane. Braxton has the rebound, almost lost it, now goes to the hoop for two, and it's blocked on the play by Powell. Blocked again by Donald Powell. William Anderson has it for Illinois State, and they better reload the offense. Donald Powell has declared kill time on the defensive end. Powell had his best game of the season against Illinois State. Taphorn operating baseline, dribble down the baseline. Literally. So Illinois State turns it over, that's 5 for the Redbirds. We've got a good one brewing here. 10:35 to go, first half of play. It's a tight one in a 30-win season. You're going to have to win some close ones.
12 games by 4 points or less.
Yeah, I'd say Bradley's won more than their share of the close ones this year. Here's Bertolini, good outside shooter. First bucket of the evening for Len Bertolini. He's got 2, and Bradley has pushed back to within 3.
The one thing you can't let that young man do is shoot the jump shot without defensive pressure.
Warren Anderson drew the foul on the play. Anderson sank the shot, but it won't count. He was fouled before he released the basketball.
Shows you what kind of offensive momentum he has going on. Look at Anderson right here. He makes this move, makes a ball fake, gets the defensive player up, still gets the shot off. It did go in, folks.
Trevor Trimley picks up his first personal foul. 6 now on the Bradley Braves. Jeff Harris crossing in on the inbound for Illinois State. Trimpy kicks it away. What do they say in hockey? Kick, save, and a beauty?
Hey.
Huh?
The guy is versatile. Wayne Larrabee is versatile.
I used to watch hockey back in the ring. I haven't seen any since. William Anderson out front now.
position number 25. Jeff Harris. Here's William Anderson. Bradley packing in that zone defense. Tap point, feeding inside. Sanders again on the turn. Boy, he's having an excellent first half. He has 10 points. He's playing with an awful lot of confidence. He's just wheeling with the basketball and sticking it. He just is not hesitating at all. Once again, the lead is 5 for the Redbirds. 9:34 left to go first half. Len Bertolini once again, this time over Harris. Redbirds all over the basketball. Caphorn brings it down. William Anderson in transition. Anderson on the drive for the floater, and he gets the bounce. Perhaps the magic is still in the release of William Anderson, of what this youngster for the Illinois State, William Anderson. Here comes Anderson once again. Anderson kicks it back to Caphorn, but he's off the step.
Well, he got a little excited that time. He over-penetrated with a basketball. He was going faster than he should have been going. And we have the violation as a result of it.
Bob Donawald regroups his Redbirds. 9:04 left to go. This is the Missouri Valley Basketball Network.
An incredible discovery that the blizzard was moving in fast. Only snappers could get the job done in time. All built tough, from the compact single stage with its 200-degree chute to the...
S&K Chevrolet, your more-for-less dealer, Knoxville and Pioneer Parkway, Peoria.
Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week being brought to you by State Farm. For a good price and great service and all your family insurance needs, check with a State Farm agent nearest you.
This statistic tells you something. 6 rebounds for Illinois State, converted to 8 points. 2 rebounds for Bradley, converted to 0 points.
Jimmy Less on the wing now for the Bradley Braves. That'll foul down low. Trippy, wide open top of the key. Less following on the rebound. Trippy, bullet feed down low. Jerry Thomas, good read by Trevor Trippy.
Very fine diagonal interior feed by Trippy that Thomas handled well.
Sanders baseline, he's been hot.
He wants the basketball. He wants the ball.
He's got 12. He's got 12. They're going to have to collapse on him, Coach. Bradley works the ball around the perimeter. Braves are trailing by 7. We've got 8:15 left to go. First half of play. Howell forces one up on Braxic. No foul call. Sanders takes the rebound. 5 rebounds, Derek Sanders. Here's Taphorn baseline. Good fake around Powell. Jerry Thomas the rebound. Jimmy Less on the run. 2-on-2 play. Less pulls up. Taphorn is there for the rebound. Illinois State comes back the other way. Still leading by 7. William Anderson shot 30% the first half of the season, 56% down the stretch, and he connects again. The lead is 9 for Illinois State, and the Bradley Braves are going to take a timeout. 7:42 left to be played, first half. The Redbird is happy. We'll be back after these local messages.
Satisfied customers talk about Pekin New Car Dealers.
We shop all around.
But we found our best deal with the Pekin New Car Dealers.
I thought I saved several hundred dollars. After shopping with some of the other communities in the area, I came back to Pekin and felt that I got the best deal right here at the Pekin New Car Dealers.
I've gotten my best deals from Pekin area.
These new car owners save by shopping in Pekin. You can too. For the best selection of new cars at the best price, see your Pekin New Car Dealer today.
I got the best price at the Pekin New Car Dealers.
You know, when most folks think of an IRA account, they look pretty much like I do. But that's not right, because an IRA account's not just a retirement account. It's a tax-saving account. And you should be thinking of opening your Sheridan Bank IRA when you look like this. You see, the more you save, the less you pay in taxes. And that's good news come refund time. There's no better time than now to open your Sheridan Bank IRA account at the one-of-a-kind bank, because you're one-of-a-kind.
Oh, hey, come on. Got a minute?
Sure.
I saw what you did for my neighbor.
Most people come to Chem Lawn because of the work we've done for their neighbors.
Tell me what.
Besides feeding your lawn, our people are specially trained to control the weeds and insects that can damage it. This kind of service is what makes Chem Lawn different, and it's why we can guarantee you a healthier, more beautiful lawn or your money back.
Excuse me, Chem Lawn, you got a minute?
Be right with you. Call now for Chem Lawn Care. We give our people better training, they give you a better lawn.
Yeah.
Bob Orr to go. Missouri Valley Conference postseason tournament semifinal action of the first half.
You want to know why Bradley is struggling? They're 5 out of 18 in the field for 27%. Illinois State, meanwhile, 12 out of 23 for 52%.
Jim Lassen trying to get by William Anderson. Here's Trevor Trimby. They go on the weave to who? Powell or Thomas? Trimby finally picks up. Find the interior feed to Thomas. It's loose on the floor. We got a foul coming up. It's going to be on Jeff Harris of Illinois State. Hawkins hit the deck.
You know, Wayne, I might mention that the Coach Versace has been very calm, very cool in the timeouts yesterday against West Texas State and here against Illinois State until the last one. And the last one, there were some strong words directed at point guard Jimmy Less and some of the other players, and I'm sure that that was just plain and simply from the standpoint they needed to be reminded they were not doing their job. I don't think he's happy with their shot selection at the offensive end of the floor.
Hawkins has just 1 point so far tonight. We've got 7:20 to go in the first half of play. Sanders has the rebound. Illinois State's William Anderson takes it across.
Not a lot of things are going well for the Bradley Braves right now.
They played under adverse situations before, though.
They sure have, and come out a winner.
Jeff Harris looking for room. Trimpy right out there to get him. They've got to contain Sanders is the key in this matchup, it looks like. Down low, Sanders has been running wild, so to speak. There's the scoring margin.
Illinois State beating its opponents.
Harris off the mark to the outside, down low, but Peterson won't go, and Thomas takes it off the floor. Jimmy Less pushes it up in a hurry. Trimpy on the wing, now Less looking for the shot, takes it, and he's short. Sanders with another rebound. Six rebounds for Derek Sanders, in addition to 12 points. Trimpy out of field to the back.
Anderson is really excited, very, very emotional. He's up for the basketball game. He knows what it means to play against Bradley. He's been around for 4 years. Here's a good look at him. Look at this pass. You talk about a diagonal pass with authority. Handled very well down low by 45 Hollenfield. That's a good job, good pair of hands by Tony Hollenfield.
A pump fake through the foul on Jerry Thomas, his first. Now the Bradley Braves are over the foul limit. Mike Williams back into the lineup for Bradley. Here's Hollenfield of the free throw line. Sophomore from Oak Park, Michigan. Started throughout much of the season, but has been coming off the bench down the stretch this year. Completes the three-point play. The 12-point lead is the largest of the evening. Illinois State on top. Bradley's got to get it going. Greg Jones also in the ballgame for Bradley, giving the Braves a lot of muscle down low. Manuel on the drive. Baseline. Lost his pivot foot. Mentioned the looks on the faces of the three coaches, Matt Mano Versace and Rudy Keeling, say it all. Another turnover for Bradley, the seventh of the first half by the Braves. We've got 5:56 left to go in the first half of play. The lead is 12 for Illinois State.
They're going to have to get Percy Hawkins.
Pamhorn trying to force it down low. Williams intercepts. Here comes Manuel. Manuel had it tapped away from behind by Peterson, a picked up by Pamhorn, and Manuel trying to get the ball back. It's called for the foul.
Manuel's had a couple of, had a turnover, and then turned the ball over there when it was recovered, committed the foul. So he's had some problems since he's been in there. We see him right there losing control of the basketball. Pamhorn reaches down. Manuel comes in from behind, reaching. It's called for the foul.
So Manuel picks up his first personal foul. Team is over the limit. 4 points from that tap horn tonight of the first half. His first trip to the charity stripe. Peterson over the back of Jones on the rebound of the foul is called. They are calling it tight, no question about that. Ron Zetcher with the call right away. That's the first personal foul on Greg Jones. We still have 5:38 left to go. Both teams have been over the foul limit for quite some time. Dick Versace talking with Anthony Manuel, the young freshman out of Chicago, Illinois. Manuel came into the game in place of Jim Less here in the first half.
Well, they absolutely have to have their free throws. The 28-16 lead by Illinois State. You have to capitalize on those opportunities, and they're not doing that.
Anderson pried it loose and took it away. William Anderson sets it up. What a tournament he's having. Jeff Harris from deep in the corner. Trimpy MVC has the rebound. Manuel pushes it across to the Bradley Bray. Percy Hawkins on a quick release, and he connects.
I'm telling you, there's the guy that's got to come into the game. He must make his presence felt at the offensive end of the floor, but he can't do it if he doesn't have the basketball.
He's only got 3 points in this first half. We've got a little over 5 minutes left to go first half to play. The Hawk has to get involved, no question about that. They must involve him in the offense, like you said. Jeff Harris on the wing. Horn working the point. William Anderson, number 25 of the lower portion of your screen. There he is. Illinois ceiling baseline. Harris ran out of real estate. And it'll belong to Bradley as Harris stepped out of bounds.
I'll tell you what, Bob Donowall, I'm not happy with this. This is a force all the way. There's no place for Harris to go. Absolutely no place to go. He goes out of bounds before there's any contact made there.
Well, I tell you, the turnovers have added up both sides. Anderson almost tried another turnover loose as he knocked it out of bounds. There's Dick Versace company. Bradley is 0-3 on 1-1 free throw opportunities in this first half of play.
You know, Coach Versace making a move right here, sending a message to Jimmy Less, I think.
Here's Hersey Hawkins. Yeah, you're right, Less been out of the ballgame for about 2 or 3 minutes now.
That's right.
Trevor Trippi looking for room, finds it, and can't hit the shot. Taken off the floor by Todd Starks. Here's William Anderson. Illinois State in control, leading by 10. 4:10 left to go, first half. Anderson ducks inside. Todd Starks looks for a better shot and finds it off the glass, but it won't go. Peterson the rebound for two. And the lead again is 12 for Illinois State.
Not only a good offensive rebound, but a very quick second effort off the floor. He's a quick jumper. He went right back with that basketball.
Cliff Peterson off the bench has provided a lift. He had 5 rebounds against Wichita State in the first round game. Looked like a foul either on Anderson or Stark.
It's Anderson.
It's Anderson. He reached over and tried to knock the ball away. Starks also slapped at it. Whenever you see a player reach out and grab or slap, you're going to soon hear a whistle. And that was the case. Anthony Manuel at the free throw line now for the Bradley Braves.
Tell you what, the way Illinois State flows with the ball defensively, I mean, they've always got 2 or 3 guys around the ball. You can call a foul on almost anyone.
Well, they're a situation.
They're a ball-conscious defensive team, that's for sure.
Manuel nets the first free throw. He'll have another.
And the defensive principle we've talked about that they implement so very well is dropping to the point of the ball. If you watch their defensive people, they know where the basketball is. They drop to it very, very well.
Manuel 13 of 19 to the free throw line coming in. Well, Bradley back to within 10. 3:40 left to go, first half of play. This is William Anderson. Illinois State on the attack. Anderson over Greg Jones. Rebound taken down by big Mike Williams of the Bradley Braves. 4 rebounds for Williams here in the first half. Bradley, the ninth-ranked team in the nation. Williams inside for two and a foul.
I'll tell you what, that was a clinic on movement of the ball at the offensive end of the floor. They did a very fine job, moved the ball. Williams pinned his man defensively. Good pass inside. Look at this. Good quick pass, a touch pass right there. Williams moving well as the ball moved. Very fine execution. I'll tell you, they're scratching and clawing their way back into this thing with some key players on the bench wing.
Hollifield picks up his first personal foul. Now Williams, who has 9 points, is 3 out of 4 at the line here tonight. Make it 4 out of 5. He's in double digits with 10 points. Bradley is back to within 7.
With the dynamic duo, Jimmy Less and Hersey Hawkins on the bench.
Illinois State working the ball. Redbirds need a hoop right here, Coach, wouldn't you say?
Well, they sure do.
Extend the tide, so to speak.
And the pace is slowed just a little bit. The tempo's not quite as quick as it was earlier in the ballgame.
I would think a quick tempo would favor Bradley, but that has not been the trend here tonight.
That's correct. We thought that coming in, but Illinois State responded to that challenge very well.
Peterson to the corner. Illinois State showing great patience. Less than 10 seconds to go on the shot clock. 5 seconds to go. Starks releases. Rebound tapped out of bounds. Last touch by the Bradley Braves.
Okay, let's go.
Peterson comes out of the ball game, and they pick number 54, Bill Praxic, reports back on the 7-footer from Flanagan, Illinois.
You know, a real important factor right there for Illinois State is that they get the ball back with another 45 seconds on the shot clock.
Illinois State leading by 7 of the first half against nationally ranked Bradley. Hollifield had the scoop and the shot was blocked off the backboard, and goaltending is the call. Greg Jones came down with the basketball. Watch it again.
Good move by Hollifield inside. He can pin that ball as long as he gets it on the way up.
Greg Jones for a big man gets off the floor, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
Len Bertolini, weak side. Into the open pop by Anderson. He connects. Bertolini with two from the field has four. Bradley remains within 7. Coming up on the 2-minute mark, left to be played, first half. Tap one to William Anderson. Todd starts on the wing. Minute 50 left to go, first half. Hollifield!
Excellent move on the baseline. Strong power move. He went up and dumped it with two hands.
Manuel trying to kick it back outside after penetrating. Threw it right to Taphorn, but Rich Eichhorst has the foul. And it's going to be offensive against Manuel. Watch this one.
Look at the move by Hollifield, number 45 right there. He gets down along the baseline, powers up in, and strong. Gets the two-hand dunk.
Second personal foul on Anthony Manuel. Hollifield at the free throw line. He accepted the contact and drew the offensive foul. Peterson reports on for Illinois State. Jim Les comes back on for the Bradley Braves.
He's been out a long time. They've been playing without him for a long time. They're not accustomed to that. The same with Hawkins. Let's see if their presence on the floor gives them any momentum at all going in to halftime.
Minute 35 to go, first half. Bradley trailing by 9. This is Hersey Hawkins. Hawkins looking to operate now against Peterson. Over Peterson he goes. Todd Starks comes away with the basketball. Here's William Anderson, quickly to Hollifield, inside and Hawkins, the ball blocked by Powell and Hawkins. Jim Les comes back the other way. Minute 13 left to go. First half of play. Again, Bradley down by 9. This is Donald Powell. Good feed to Greg Jones on the fade. He comes up with an air ball. Braxic clears to William Anderson. Less than a minute to go. 40 on the shot clock, 54 on the game clock. This inside Illinois State
tells you something about it. That's primarily Derek Sanders and Hollifield. Illinois State 20 points inside, only 8 for Bradley.
Yeah, that's with Mike Williams in the ball game, and he has just dominated in the paint down the stretch for Bradley this season. Braves hold pressure until Illinois State has to kick the offense in gear. 15 to go on the shot clock,
25 on the game clock.
8 seconds left to go now. The shot clock. Todd starts. 4 seconds on the shot clock. They're going to have to get it away. The fourth shot by Peterson bounces high in the air and over the backboard. Bradley has 14 seconds with which to work. Plenty of time to set up for a good shot.
And I think a key possession because it takes them into the locker room. If they could score here, it gives them a little bit of momentum and it may affect the second half. Let's see what happens.
There's the game clock lower right of your screen. Jimmy Les to Trevor Trimpe. Back to Les. Les is going to take it from there. A long carom to Todd Starks, and he doesn't have to shoot. Illinois State at halftime. And what may be developing into the upset of the tournament, leads their arch rivals, the nationally ranked Bradley Braves, by 9. A lot of folks of Central Illinois are here, and the camps are split at the moment. We'll be back after these local messages.
This health message could change your life. Do you suffer from neck pain, headaches, blurred vision, shoulder pain, arm pain, numb hands, back pain, hip pain, pain down the legs? If you have any of these symptoms, call the Shelley Chiropractic Office. We'll accept your insurance assignment, which means we'll wait for payment until your insurance check comes in.
Remember, if you wear out your body, where are you going to live?
Call Dr. Shelley today at 682-6624. It could change your life.
It's an Uptrink Chevy Ol special purchase. 30 1986 S10 pickups with over $1,100 worth of free options have just arrived. Free automatic overdrive transmission, free tinted glass and bright mirrors, and special paint, all free. Plus 12 Chevy Astro conversion vans loaded with comfort and convenience, starting at only $14,895. Don't miss this special purchase sale on S10 pickups and Astro conversion vans. Now at Uptrink Chevy Ol's, where Oldsmobiles are always on sale.
What you do?
Domino's Pizza delivers
for two. Just for you.
Domino's Pizza delivers doubles.
Get two great pizzas for one special price. Domino's Pizza delivers doubles. You can select different toppings on each delicious pizza, and we deliver in less than 30 minutes. So call.
And get two. That's right, two.
Domino's Pizza delivers doubles.
Staying in touch can make a big difference in your world. Saving money can make a big difference in your budget. And getting in touch with TMC can help you do both. Because TMC can make a difference in your long distance. Find out how. Get in touch with TMC.
With TMC long distance.
Tulsa, Oklahoma semifinal action of the Missouri Valley Conference postseason basketball tournament. Strange things happen in tournaments, although I don't know if folks in Central Illinois could ever call it really an upset if Illinois State beats Bradley, and I say that because of the rivalry factor. You never know who's going to win this game. Doesn't matter if Bradley's 30-1 and nationally ranked in the top 10. Illinois State's going to go at them, and they haven't been intimidated at all.
Well, they certainly have not, and I promise you, if the shoe was on the other foot, Bradley would go at Illinois State the same way. They just did not play well in the first half, Wayne. However, I think that was because of Illinois State. Not so much of what Bradley didn't do, but what Illinois State did do. I was most impressed with the defensive pressure they were able to put on Hawkins. Not after he got the basketball, because he didn't get it very often, but they just were able to keep the basketball away from him. Les could not have a good first half. And I promise you, when Jimmy Les and Hersey Hawkins don't play well, Bradley's going to struggle just a little bit. Now, we know they're a great basketball team, and we know that they'll have a better second half, but they better really have a good second half, because Illinois State is playing well.
They certainly are. They won a tough game over Wichita State, a very physical game in the first round in the Redbirds, a game that saw 63 fouls committed. Now watch some of this action right here. The Redbirds on the attack. Get a look at it down low, and that's Bill Braxick, who did a good job inside, and he just blows to the hoop. Powell knocks it away. Braxick gets it right back. Powell again on the defensive end. Donald Powell exploding, but Illinois State comes up with a basketball to the person of William Anderson, and they reload the offense. So that's the way it's gone in the first half. Been a frustrating first half for Dick Versace and company, but again, we've still got an entire second half to go. Take a look at some of the numbers of this ballgame. Sanders with 12 points and 6 rebounds, and he did much of the damage in the paint for Illinois State.
Well, he certainly did. Illinois State's just played well. Well prepared. You know, we talked about it at the top of the show. They're really prepared to operate against the matchup zone that Bradley's played. Don't be surprised if we see some man-to-man defense in the second half. Defensive pressure extended a little bit by the Braves to see if they can't get some easy baskets at the offensive end of the floor.
All right, we're at halftime. Illinois State leading Bradley, and we'll be back after these messages. This is the Missouri Valley Basketball Network.
There's a world of difference in TWA. It's the difference between getting you where you're going and leading the way.
Patience. It's probably the one thing I remember most when I first learned about Coors Beer. You know, from the time they take to malt their own barley, brewing, aging, the whole process. They never hurry or take shortcuts. It's really kind of neat. You know, I found that they took 10 years to develop just one strain of barley. 10 whole years. They aged their beer longer than any other major brewer. They even refrigerate their hops. takes about twice as long to make Coors as it does any other beer. I'm not saying that these guys take forever, but they do take their time. And you can taste the difference right here. A better tasting beer? If you're looking for a beer that's a little less heavy, never bitter, but with all the spirit and patience of a great beer, Coors is the one.
State Farm is there when women need life insurance.
Whether she brings home a paycheck or works full-time at home, nobody does more for a family than a mother does. That's why so many women talk to State Farm agents about life insurance. We listen, and we help make sure that everything a woman wants to do for her kids gets done. I know how she feels. I have a family, too.
Just like a good neighbor.
Today's Game of the Week is being brought to you in part by State Farm. For a good price and great service on all your family insurance, check with the State Farm agent nearest you. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Coors Light, the Silver Bullet. There's no slowing down with a Silver Bullet. And by TWA, leading the way, TWA. Time in Tulsa, Oklahoma. The winner of tonight's first game takes on the winner of Tulsa and Drake coming up in the second half of our doubleheader down here at the semifinals of the Missouri Valley Conference Basketball Tournament. You know, this time of year, it's always great to kind of look back, and with the influx of music videos over the course of the years, we thought it might be a good idea to put some music to some memories from the 85-86 Valley season.
Baxter of Maple Drive has been shoveling since 7 a.m.
It's 7:45, and his neighbor's just now getting out in his driveway. They both have to be at work by 8. Who do you think's going to be late? Escape the scrape. Take the bus. Here's Max and Pam.
The best for less.
Pam, we just got to tell everyone about Hamptons. Their stores are really fantastic.
Tell me about it. Beautiful cabinets.
Plus, top quality appliances like Maytag, GE, KitchenAid, and JennAir. All at discount prices.
No wonder they're growing.
Sure. Hamptons give people better quality and better service at a better price.
And they're nice
the
people.
Best for less. Every day.
You can trust John Deere's Ford Subaru for the biggest selection, the lowest price, and the best service.
That's a promise.
You'll find a constantly changing inventory of over 300 new and used cars and trucks.
That's a promise.
You'll always get a fair deal and the lowest price.
That's a promise.
You'll get fast, fair, professional repairs and service.
That's a promise.
You'll get the most for your dollar from the people you can trust at John Deere's Ford Subaru. That's a promise.
Deluxe Homes is having its biggest RV sale ever.
Every used RV on the lot is going in rock-bottom prices. And we're closing out many of the best names in motorhomes.
Holiday Rambler, Rainbow, Midas, RVC Legend, and more. None of these models will be restocked. New and used motorhomes and travel trailers must go. Buy now while every vehicle is discounted thousands of dollars to wholesale and below.
We're Central Illinois' largest Winnebago motorhome dealer. So see me, Bill Butler, the man with the cigar, and save thousands at Deluxe Homes in Peoria.
When you're in Tulsa, try Beechwood's Restaurant for a fabulous all-you-can-eat buffet served Monday through Friday from 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. That's Beechwood's Restaurant, 41st and Garnett in the Tulsa Marriott Hotel. Illinois State back on the floor, getting set for second half action. We're going to get a look at some of the numbers of this first half of play here.
Illinois State, 16 out of 35 for 45% shooting. Not great shooting, but not bad. But look at Bradley, really struggling from the field. Shooting only 30.7%, 8 out of 26. Free throw line, Bradley gets the edge there, 9 out of 13. Illinois State's only been there four times. They've converted two of them. 24 rebounds for Illinois State. They get the edge there, and that's a telltale statistic, certainly. Bradley only 17 rebounds. Turnovers, too many for both teams, really. 8 for Illinois State, 9 for Bradley, but that'll happen in a game of this nature. Fouls, 11 against Illinois State, 9 against Bradley. So it's plain and simply field goal shooting right now, the most important statistic in the game.
Look at Sanders, 12 points. That's on 6 of 10 shooting through the field. He also has 8 rebounds. He has dominated in this first half. Hollifield off the bench hit his 3 field goal attempts. He has 7 points and 1 out of 2 at the free throw line. And they lead the scoring for a well-balanced Illinois State team. Take a look at the Bradley Braves. Williams, 3 of 5 from the floor, 4 out of 5 from the free throw line, 10 points and 5 rebounds. But the note here, Hersey Hawkins just 3 points on 1 of 3 shooting from the floor. Isn't that the basketball whole lot?
Yeah, that's we've talked about that throughout the first half, and that was very obvious early. I mentioned first trip down the floor that Taphorn was taking Hawkins, and he was really trying to stay up tight against him and not allow him to have the basketball. Other people did guard him on occasion throughout the first half, but I think that's the big difference. And when you combine that with the fact that Jimmy Les did not play well in the first half, that's the answer as far as the Bradley Braves are concerned. However, you're talking about a couple of guys. A senior in Les is the player of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference and an outstanding sophomore in Hersey Hawkins. You watch them come back this half. They'll have to come back because Illinois State is ready mentally, very well prepared physically. They just had an excellent first half, and I would anticipate that they will continue to play every bit as hard and intelligently. Wayne,
let me bounce this off of you. Yesterday afternoon's victory over West Texas State was the first victory by the Bradley Braves in the Missouri Valley postseason tournament that came on the road.
You know, that's a surprising statistic. Not a lot of people realize that. All of their MVC tournament victories have come at home. And in addition, combine that with this one. Illinois State has never lost in the Missouri Valley Conference under Donerwald to an MVC opponent three times
in one season. Right. Now, if they were to beat Bradley tonight, that would stop that streak. Now, if Tulsa was to advance over Drake, then, again, the Redbirds would be in that same position of being up against it, having lost twice to Tulsa during the regular season. There are the starters for the second half. Powell, Trippi, and Williams up front for the Bradley Braves. Weston Hawkins to backcourt.
We'll take a look early to see if we can point out any very noticeable material changes that might be made here by the Bradley Braves.
Illinois State starts on offense. Redbirds leading it by nine. This is William Anderson. Cap Horn on the wing. They'll give him the outside shot for the most part. They're not going to give that guy anything from the outside. He was lighting it up yesterday.
Illinois State would love to have a high percentage shot with this first possession of the second half.
Sanders on way to a high percentage shot, tied up by Donald Powell, who picks up the first foul of the second half. But on Powell, it is number three.
Once again, this is something good happening for Illinois State because they did run time off the clock with that ball possession. Now they get the ball back and have another 45 seconds.
Look at there. High percentage shot opportunity for William Anderson, and he's clobbered down low.
Must know where people are offensively. Powell did not know where William Anderson was. He turned his back on him, and at that point, Anderson made a very good move, trying to go baseline to come in behind him, from behind him, which he did. They got him the ball, and he drew the foul.
They got three personal fouls now on Donald Powell. William Anderson at the free throw line. Anderson's first trip to the charity stripe line. He's two out of three from the floor. Now he has 5 points as he's one of one at the charity stripe.
He likes to be there.
Excellent free throw shooter down the stretch for the Illinois State Redbirds. He missed one. Finally. He had made 37 of his last 39 free throw attempts, 38 out of 40. Till that miss right there. Trevor Trippi now sets it up for Bradley. We've got some pushing and shoving away from the ball. Bill Braxick says, what about you, Coach?
Well, I think you'll see here for the first 2 or 3 minutes, once again, the officials will call things very closely to make sure that control is maintained.
Second personal on Braxick, only the first on Illinois State. Opening 2 minutes of play in this second half. Anderson comes away with a basketball. His outlet pass stolen by Hawkins to Jimmy West.
Hawkins and West. Those two can get it rolling.
West pressuring in the backcourt, but he's the only Brave back. And Taphorn moves it across easily. Taphorn gets room on the baseline from Jerry Thomas, and Thomas pushed him. It was plain as day.
Wasn't any question about that call. You could have made that call, Wayne.
I did. Watch it again.
Here's Taphorn right here. Thomas picks him up on a switch defensively, and you see the hands on him. He had his left hand on it. His right hand was in the small of his back.
Just can't do that. Thomas picks up his second personal. That's already the third team foul on Bradley here in the second half. Two of which have been called on Donald Powell in the second half. Tap one out of point. Bradley in his own defense off the out-of-bounds play.
How about the performance of a young Illinois State team with only one senior?
Braxick up high. William Anderson, the lone senior. Jumped at by Mike Williams. Well, that's scare almost anybody. Harris from the corner connects. Jeff Harris, reminder, he had 19 points yesterday against Wichita State. He has 5 here tonight. Jimmy West settles down to Bradley Braves. They trail by 10. Williams inside on Braxick. No good but a foul. They are going to have to go down low, Bob.
Well, they've got to go down low, and once again, I think they have to get shots. We see it right. They're going to get shots for Hawkins. You see Mike Williams with a strong move in the basket right there. He's making it very difficult on Braxick. Braxick got caught a little bit on the side of him. That's why the foul was committed. Once the man gets in front of you, you've got a problem. If you're going to front him, you've got to start there and stay there. If you're going to play behind him, then start there and stay there.
Williams is 4 out of 5 from the line. He has 11 points now. Had an outstanding game yesterday. 18 points, 10 rebounds against West Texas State. He was 8 out of 10 from the field. He led the Valley in field goal percentage shooting. Bradley is back to within 8. Almost 2 minutes into the second half of play. You're watching Illinois State on offense. Jeff Harris out front. away from the ball as Trevor Krimpe, in his attempt to get to Matt Caphorn, pushed Jeff Harris to the foul. Is the second on Krimpe, but the fourth on the team. And again, we're not even 3 minutes into this second half of play. Jeff Harris for Illinois State. Harris wants to go inside of practice. It's not there. Williams playing good defense down low.
I think the man-to-man defense having an effect on Illinois State in terms of the flow of their offense.
Caphorn out of the corner.
That was a great statement, wasn't it? Caphorn gets the ball and sticks it.
He's got 6 points now. 17 and a half minutes left to go in this game. 10-point lead once again for Illinois State.
I really do think that can be a determining factor, though, if Bradley stays man-to-man.
Williams in a crowd down low. Position was not established by Caphorn. The foul called. Third on Matt Caphorn. Third on the team.
He was late. You can see it here. There's the pass down low to Williams. He was late getting there. Caphorn.
None shooting up there. The Braves will inbound. Trevor Krimpe on the trigger.
Less than 3 minutes. 7 fouls called.
Talk about tight. Will there be anybody left at the halfway point at this rate? Gary Thomas inserted into the lineup now. Bradley Braves. Williams on the turn and it won't go. Thomas the rebound. A tough rebound and a tough bucket by Gary Thomas.
He had a big basket the first half and that was a good job there. That ankle's not bothering him too much, I'll tell you that. There's a trap by Bradley.
Harris clears the ball and for the foul out, it won't go for Derek Sanders. Williams had the rebound and we got a foul coming up.
Now we're seeing a swing in momentum right here. It very definitely is taking place. I mean, the momentum hasn't swung over the Bradley Braves, but we're in the process of seeing a swing. You look at the foul problems for Illinois State. Sanders, Braxton, Caphorn with three. Donald Powell with three for the Bradley Braves.
Anderson has two. 14 fouls on Illinois State. Jimmy West sets up the offense. Hawkins from deep. Sanders up high for the rebound. Illinois State on the attack. William Anderson guarded by Jimmy West. From the backcourt on, Les is going to play at 90 feet. Bumping by Les, and on Jimmy Les, he picks up another foul. That's his second.
That's not the place you want to make body contact. You don't want to make body contact out here. Everybody in the world can see it.
Five team fouls now.
You got to get down low, move your feet, and keep that good position, keeping the basketball in front of you when you're playing defense that far out on the floor. Jimmy knows that.
A little over 3.5 minutes into the second half, we've had 9 fouls in this half alone. A good feed to Braxton down low, off the glass, yes, and a foul. Yes, and it counts.
Here's the big guy inside. Caphorn with a pretty good pass. Williams did get a piece of it, but Braxton got it back. Gets it up off the glass. Was in the air when he got fouled.
Mike Williams picks up his second, 6 on the team, and Braxton at the line looking for a 3-point play. And he gets it. So it's an 11-point lead now for Illinois State. 16-13 left to go. Bradley's only loss back in December to Clemson in the Rainbow Classic.
There was an attempt to get Hawkins a shot there. I think they have to do more of that.
Williams down low, spins to the hoop, and yes, it drops.
Very good move on Williams' part. He's really concentrating on putting that basketball inside to him.
Right now, he's been the breadwinner for them.
Illinois State continues to answer, though.
There he is. Williams on the corner.
No defensive pressure there at all. Somebody's going to have to come up tight on him. The young man's capable of shooting the ball well.
8 points for Caphorn now. Again, the lead is 11 for Illinois State. Bradley Braves, ninth ranking in both the AP and UPI polls this morning. Gary Thomas inside, back to Jimmy West for the perimeter jump, and he's got it. 15-18 left to go. 6 points for Jimmy West.
Bradley in the defense, they call number one. That's a man-to-man defense, obviously.
Derek Sanders. Now William Anderson, number 25. That's Caphorn from deep. He fires. Williams has the rebound position, and the foul is on Braxton, and that's 4 on Bill Braxton.
And that's not a shot that Caphorn should be taking. The last few times down the floor when he had shots on the right wing, there was no defensive pressure there. He forces that shot just a little bit. Williams was in good position, inside position on the board, practicing. There's no way he can go over the top of Williams because of Williams' jumping ability, size, and bulk.
There's the Bradley huddle. This is the Missouri Valley Basketball Network.
An incredible discovery that the blizzard was moving in fast. Only snappers could get the job done in time. All built tough, from the compact single stage with its 200-degree chute to the mid-size two-stage that throws snow where you want it, up to the full-size two-stage that shifts into action on the big drifts with winterized muscle to spare. They got the job done in plenty of time. And our real discovery was how easy those snappers made clearing snow. Easy to own, too, with Snap Credit.
Who's gonna be at the Silver Bullet tonight?
I mean, are you Irish?
No. Sipping on a cold Coors Light. Are you right?
No Irish at all.
Who's gonna come and play on a Coors Light St. Patrick's Day?
Come on, you're Irish.
Okay, I'm Irish.
That's funny, you don't look Irish.
No slowing down for the Silver Bullet tonight. So look for this display with beer. Well, I'm Irish. Wherever you buy Coors and Coors Light beer.
Life is full of changes, and State Farm is there.
I'm State Farm Agent George Pommey. If your family's like mine, you'll find reminders of how fast things change. It wasn't so long ago my daughter Jill was riding in this. Now she drives this. Look around you. If you see your insurance needs have changed, auto, home, life, or health, see your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. The advice is free.
Like a good neighbor.
And the decisions are yours.
Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference game is being brought to you by State Farm for a good price and great service on all your family insurance needs. Check with a State Farm agent nearest you. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Bradley doing something about that poor first half shooting percentage. They are 4-for-6 here in the second half to 66%. Illinois State go 4 out of 5 for 80.
Yeah, they match it against some. Williams down low for 2. I think that's the breadwinner right there, Bob. They're going to go to Mike Williams. They feel they have to.
That's obviously their game plan.
They've got Bill Braxick on the bench with 4 personal fouls. Now Hollifield is in the ball game in the pivot for Illinois State.
And we continue to see the man-to-man D out of Bradley.
Les leaped over and grabbed Hollifield on the way to the bucket. 3rd personal on Jimmy Les. 6th on the team. My goodness, we still have 4:26 to go.
14:26, Wayne.
Make that 7 fouls on Bradley, 5 on Illinois State. So the Braves already over the foul limit. Yeah, you're right, 14:26 left to go. What did I say, 4:26?
Well, you're a little excited.
Yeah, right. Black Yonder and I am. The first. I don't have your court sense about me yet. 2 out of 3 at the line for Hollifield. Sophomore from Oak Park, Michigan, and he misses on the second, and Thomas is there to claim the rebound. Now for the Bradley Braves. This is clever quickly, number 40, guarded by Jeff Harris. Getting it down low, Williams on the turnaround, blocked by Hollifield. Taken off the play by Eric Sanders.
Hollifield with a greater vertical jump than Braxick is able to get up and get a piece of that shot.
Harrison won't go. Rebound through several hands. Trimpy latches on to Les Thomas on the drive.
Great pass and a great pair of hands by Thomas. And an excellent shot, a tough shot, but he got it down.
And that Dick Versace up off the bench. That may spark the Bradley Braves. That's the way they got it going against West Texas State in the opening round. Illinois State looking for the stopper.
Bradley's excited right now. They've made a move here. Let's see how Illinois State counters that.
Illinois State looking to stem the tide. Harris wants a better shot. There's Matt Caphorn, guarded by Trimpy. William Anderson has been much quieter tonight than he was yesterday afternoon against Wichita State when he scored 30. Anderson now out of the point. Off the pick by Taphorn. It won't go for Sanders, but a foul on Jerry Thomas. Thomas trying to fight through the screen. There's Dick Versace, demonstrative argument on the call. 3rd personal on Jerry Thomas.
His words right there, Coach Versace's words, were moving screen. He felt like the man setting the pick for the shooter, Taphorn, was moving him.
13-13 left to go. Matt Taphorn at the free throw line. Sophomore from Pekin, Illinois. sophomore did not score against Wichita State University. He's one out of two at the free throw line here tonight.
I'll Peterson promise you.
They're up off the bench for Bob Donwald coming in. Cliff Peterson in a moment. Capone makes the pair.
There have been some great high school basketball players come out of Pekin, Illinois. Buddy Miller, Barry Moran, Matt Capone, Mark Schleidinger now coaching at University of Kansas.
Jim Les takes it across now. We have about a 13-minute mark left to be played. Illinois State leading it by 18, by 8 points. Trevor Trippi feeding down low to Williams. And a foul coming up inside, and this one's going to be called on Derek Sanders, who
that look says, well, wait a minute.
Can't believe that one. That's his point.
Let's see what happens here. They continue to go after that inside game.
Sanders is just standing there.
Bradley really emphasizing that. I think they need a little offense.
There's this foul trouble right there. 16 fouls now in Illinois State. Bradley already over the limit. 12:45 to go. Jimmy Les. Williams trying on the tap, knocks it out of play.
They need some offense at some point in other areas
besides William.
Yes, sir.
This is William Anderson. That's Hathorn in the corner.
Getting it down to 7 or 8 points, but they can't get inside that mark.
Three fouls on Sanders. We had him for four. It's three. Got a whistle down low away from the ball. This one's on Kurt Peterson. Bob Donwald up off the bench. More upset with his player rather than the official. No. Second personal foul on Peterson. Dick Versace on the Bradley bench.
Donwald wasn't upset with the official at all on that one, but he was a little bit unhappy with number 32, Cliff Peterson.
And that foul put Illinois State over the foul limit.
Another 6'8", 200-pound sophomore for Illinois State. The future looks bright for both of these teams. You know, when you talk about Bradley, you talk about seniors Les and Williams so much, you think that they're a veteran team. After that, they're a very young team.
We're second half of play, and Hawkins had just 3 points, make it four.
And I think it's the difference in the ballgame. I think it's the reason that Bradley trailed. He just has not been able to get any shots.
17 points on 6 of 11 from the field against West Texas State yesterday in opening round action. Percy Hawkins.
I'll tell you one thing about him. He's capable of getting 10, 12, 15 points. In 10 minutes.
In a hurry.
Got that right.
Now the lead has been whittled to 6.
They finally got it inside 7 or 8, and they changed their defense. Back in the zone. Let's see how that bothers Illinois State, if it does at all.
Trippi over the zone, off the glass. Peterson, the rebound over the back of Trippi. And the foul is called on Peterson.
Both shoot a 1-1.
Third personal foul on Cliff Peterson. There's Matt Caphorn.
You see the shot. Watch Peterson over the top of Trippi right there. Very obvious. Not a difficult call to make.
Trevor Trippi at the free throw line. He's got 2 points tonight. His first trip to the charity stripe. Trippi out of Atlanta, Illinois. Brings Bradley back to within 5. He can slice it to 4.
Wayne, do you see the confidence growing in the Bradley Bray?
Yep. You can sense that the momentum is on their side. If you get a look at the Bradley contingent. 12 minutes now, straight up to go. Caphorn. Anderson playing baseline. Peterson, they collapse on the ball. William Anderson now.
Now they did a good job of getting to Sanders that time.
They'd like to go inside, but against that zone, they're not able to. 1-3-1 zone defense being employed by Bradley. Hawkins at the base of that zone. Stamford up high. Illinois State on the attack. They lead by 4. Hollowfield gets room. It's blocked on the play by Hawkins and knocked out of bounds.
Boy, did you see Hersey get up on that play? He sure did.
Williams really can't contest. He's in a bit of foul trouble right now.
Hollowfield right there. What a that's Hersey Hawkins.
Behind Williams. Took it down.
Did he get up?
Jeff Harris coming into the lineup. Number 23 provides an outside shot for Illinois State.
Great play by Hersey Hawkins.
Redbirds on the attack, leading by 4. Plenty of time left to go. 11 and a half minutes remaining to be played.
He's taking a look at a different zone now against an out-of-bounds play. It's a two-man play. We the wing out of this. When the ball goes to the wing, they like to double up on that man. There it is, right there.
Trippy knocked it away, knocked it out of bounds.
They'll stay 2-3 because that's their rule.
I always flinch when I see a guy reach out and knock the ball away. I keep thinking they're going to call a foul out.
They do that frequently.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes it's an anticipatory call.
That's good.
Good word. That's a good word.
Yeah, big word for me. William Anderson out to point. Harris on the wing. Good interior feed down low. Sender makes that out of field with a good move.
Okay, that's a big basket for Illinois State.
Jimmy West plays it to Hawkins. Illinois State leading by 6 once again. Williams on the block. There's Hawkins out high. They go back to Williams. Boy, that's a game plan you can tell. No question about that. Jim Less. Thomas down low at the turn. Nicely done by Jerry Thomas. So good touch in practice.
Big basket. They're going to go back to the one-man front on the zone now. It's a 1-3-1.
Less trying to fly it loose on the steal. Hepburn. Foul field position on the rebound, and a scoop draws a foul. Mike Williams guilty of it, and here it is.
Hershey Hawkins reaches in right there. I don't think anybody has any doubts about the call. Mike Williams definitely committed the foul.
Williams playing with two, now has three. Dipper State normally will take Williams out of the lineup when he picks up his second, and he has picked up three. Now it'll be interesting to see if they make a substitution. At the moment, they are not. Hollifield just 2 out of 5 from the free throw line. 8 points here tonight. Missed the pair, and Thomas retrieves halfway through the second half.
One turnover apiece for each team. 10 fouls for Bradley, 8 for Illinois State.
Gary Thomas. Thomas bottled up looking for help. Finally lost the handle, and we got a foul. Nykhorst with the call.
This is the point at which I think the momentum that the Bradley Braves had throughout the season in terms of being so very effective in close ball games, I think they get the edge now because the Illinois State team is young, especially young at the guard position. We'll see how they handle this pressure in the last 9:44. Bradley's made a good run at him.
4 personal fouls now on Derek Sanders reaching in on that play. Thomas completes the first. He's got another. Illinois State, the way they collapsed to the ball, I'll tell you, they certainly clogged the lane, and that's where Thomas wanted to go. What Thomas has done this season. Illinois State retains possession now off the rebound by Derek Sanders. Sanders' baseline is open. Krimpe has the rebound. The outlet to Less, and here come the Braves. Less to the hoop himself, and he's got a 4 foul. Jimmy Less connects, and Bradley is back to within 1. Less can tie with a free throw.
He got a good look at the foul. There wasn't any question about it. It looked like a high fly. They were right there. Less got the ball off the glass and in.
Harris has 2 personal fouls, and Les goes to the free throw line with a chance to tie the game. So a long road back, Coach.
Well, Illinois State has played so well to this point in the game, but here in the last couple minutes, it's been all Bradley.
Les missing on the free throw. Todd Starks takes the rebound.
Boy, he'd like to have that one back.
Illinois State wants a timeout. Redbirds have played so well here tonight, but Bradley, bit by bit, cut a 12-point deficit, and now it's a 1-point ball game. This is the Missouri Valley Basketball Network.
Being there, that's what being a State Farm agent is all about.
When Scott and Vicki started to outgrow their insurance, we got together and reviewed it all. The new house, a second car, life and health coverages too. A State Farm family insurance checkup can be a big help. It's free, and it's there because things change. And like a good neighbor. Right, Jason?
Your future holds what you give it today, so give yourself this sense of security. You've heard how an IRA lets you save tax-sheltered earnings for retirement. Security Savings will show you the IRA investment options that will help you grow safely to maturity. All the advantages it takes to earn and save more for a rewarding retirement. Variable rate IRAs and lower minimum deposits on high interest time certificates. Plus up to $1,000 tax savings. Get the IRA with security built into it. Security Savings and Loan, member FSLIC.
For smart 6.9 financing, come to University Ford. Hi, I'm David Westfall, president of University Ford, with a University Ford exclusive. 6.9% financing on all new cars and trucks in stock. All month long, you'll find 6.9 financing on over 200 cars and trucks. An offer like this could save you hundreds in finance charges. But you only find 6.9 financing at Central Illinois' fastest growing Ford dealership, University Ford in Peoria, home of the smart deal.
Larry Bob Ortega watched some of the action earlier tonight. Tony Hollifield with a move on the baseline. Up and under for the reverse layup. Gets it down. You see Mike Williams, number three there for Bradley. Boy, it's been a good basketball game. We knew it would be. There wasn't any doubt in my mind, I'll promise you.
Cleveland's restaurant of the Tulsa Marriott Hotel features Sunday brunch every Sunday, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. If you're in Tulsa, stop by. State resumes offensively. Matt Taphorn, number 34. Good move by Harris to get to the baseline to Trippia. An equally fine defensive move, and then Harris finally ducks in under. Lost Trippia on the play.
Well, Trippia moved off the baseline, and I don't know why, because you want to maintain that position between the ball and the basket. When he moved off of it, Harris came up underneath it.
Mike Williams rolls to the hoop again. Had run off a string of five unanswered points before Harris rang a field goal a moment ago. Now Williams answered.
Jimmy Less is going to get one of those steals out there before this basketball game is over. He's made many attempts and has not been successful, but he's getting closer all the time.
Baseline, that's Todd Stark, the young freshman.
That timeout appeared to settle Illinois State down a little bit. Coach Donovan had a good talk with him. He was really chewing on him, I'll tell you that.
8:15 left to go in the game. Pass Tanner for Hawkins, stolen by Taphorn. Redbirds in transition. Taphorn's going to load the offense. Here's Harris. Taphorn back to the point. Harris. Illinois State working the ball now. Redbirds taking their time. There's Taphorn. To the corner, passes up the shot, out of field, over to Starks, good ball movement, and Starks connects his second in a row. He's got four.
That's that ball-sharing offense that Coach Donovan likes to implement.
Redbirds have really gotten their act together since the timeout. They now lead by five. They led by one going into the timeout. Jimmy Less looking over to the fence. Trimpy up high, they work it quickly down low. Hawkins! Boy, he can do that too.
That's the guy. Got to get him more shots.
Hawkins with 7 points now. And they have been few and far between in this game. We've got 7:07 left to go.
Got it.
Harris over to Taphorn. Down low, they go to Praxic on the slam!
The Redbirds doing a great job of answering each and every challenge Bradley throws their way.
6:48 left to go. In the first round, the teams that wore the white jerseys, the designated home teams, won all the games. Illinois State trying to reverse that trend here in the semifinals. Williams in close quarters finally finds a way to get to the basket again.
Good job of getting the shot inside by Williams against effective defensive pressure. He split the seam very well. 20 points for Williams.
These are the Redbirds of Illinois State. They still lead by three. 6:15 left to go. Taphorn works the club from the point. Starks has hit a couple in a row here. Harris. Boy, you getting any room at all. I don't care where he is. He's going to hammer it.
Boy, I'll tell you what, he loves to shoot it.
He's got nine. Again, the lead is five for Illinois State. 5:50 to go.
Mike Williams in the paint, and that's why Bertolini comes on. Trippi has a seat on the bench.
That missed free throw by Jim Les, that would have tied the score, followed by a timeout by Illinois State. It could very well be a turning point in the ballgame.
Williams trying to show a good touch. It's not there. Illinois State on the rebound by Hollifield. Takes over, leading by five. 5.5 minutes to go. The Redbirds trying to upset the nation's ninth-ranked team. Hollifield takes it back outside. Has it lost since December 28th against Clemson in the Rainbow Classic. Harris comes up short. Hollifield batting the rebound. Back half finally. Hits half hard.
And another 45 seconds.
Good interior feed down low to Hollifield from Taphorn. Didn't get the bucket, but he drew the foul on Terry Thomas. Four personal fouls on Thomas. Watch it again.
And pass inside right there to Hollifield. Pretty good defensive job right there.
5:04 left to go. Jerry Thomas leads. He's played off the bench and has played well tonight when he's been in the game. Vic Versace. He's been a little more vocal than we've seen him this year, Bob.
Well, he's not accustomed to being in this position with only 5 minutes on the clock, and he's got a big job to do, and he's doing it well. He's done it well all year. He wouldn't be the Valley Coach of the Year.
Hollifield's only 3 of 7 from the free throw stripe, but he has 11 points tonight. Powell claims the rebound. The lead is 6 points for Illinois State. Time remaining, 5 minutes. This is Jimmy Les. Bradley's what, won 12 games, 5 points or less this season. Powell down low baseline. Bertolini. Don't give him much room or he'll drill it on you. When Bertolini connects, he has three from the field of 6 points.
Got a defensive change again. You're going to see that for the remainder of the game. In transition from one end of the floor to the other, they're changing the defense.
1-3-1 zone now. Again, Hawkins at the baseline. Matt Taphorn, but I'll tell you what, the way Bradley changes defenses, it can throw an offense off, but Illinois State has hung with each and every change here tonight.
Illinois State will not change. They'll play a man-to-man.
Taphorn on the drive off the glass. Yes, it counts. Score the field goal, and Tom O'Neill's got a foul on Donald Powell. Nope, hang on. He's got the foul on Hersey Hawkins, his third.
That's just a real fine move by Matt Taphorn.
Taphorn got by Powell, and then Hawkins picked him up.
And a good shot against him. Good defensive pressure.
Hawkins just trying to help out, but picks up his third personal. Taphorn can't make it go on the three-point try. Mike Williams the rebound. This is Jimmy Les. All right, 4 minutes left to go. Len Bertolini, Jimmy Les out high. Williams down low in the paint for the swing shot that won't go. Donald Powell taps it home.
Very good job of going to the offensive glass. I saw four white shirts really go hard to the board that time for Bradley.
4-point lead, Illinois State. Redbirds on the attack. 3:35 remaining. Here's Harris. Hollifield in the lane, the feed baseline breaks it. Challenged by Williams and fouled by Mike Williams. 4 on Mike Williams. Bob Dottawall to the Illinois State bench up off the.
That was a good pass right there by Hollifield. A good job of getting the ball to the open man. Excellent job of getting the ball to the open man. You see it from another angle. Here it is again. A little shuffle pass right there to Braxton. You got to take that basket away. I know Williams didn't want to commit the foul, but he's got to take it away and make Braxton make the two free throws. So that's not all bad for Bradley at this point.
Braxton now 2 out of 2 at the charity stripe.
And Illinois State certainly is able to convert the first free throw. They'll take them any way they can get them. Braxton, they've done an excellent job.
Just a 60% free throw shooter is Bill Braxton. Moment as Bradley on the ropes. We'll be back after these local messages.
What do you like about Avanti's?
Oh,
Whether you love our pizza, pasta, or our famous gondola, Avanti's low prices and great taste will satisfy the Italian food lover in everyone.
Attention Peoria, Morton, Chillicothe, Eureka, and Metamora. If you're going to buy a new car or truck, especially if it's a Chevrolet or Nissan, you've got to go to Strickland or you're making a costly mistake. We've got a better selection, better price deals, better service than any other dealer anywhere. Sure, it's easy to say that, but we can prove it. Volume inventory on all the hard-to-get models, too, and the best pricing. So when you're ready to buy, no matter where you live, come to us and save. Strickland Chevrolet Nissan, the best of both worlds.
Hey, Mr. Versace, want some kitchen-cooked potato chips?
Nah, no thanks, kid.
But they're the greatest, Mr. Versace, just like your team.
Hey, you're all right, kid.
Thanks, Coach.
Kitchen-cooked potato chips are kettle-cooked for a hearty potato flavor the whole family will enjoy.
And I wouldn't do this commercial if I didn't eat kitchen-cooked potato chips. They're the greatest.
Kitchen-cooked potato chips and snacks, available at your grocer's.
Bob Ortico back in Tulsa. Watch this by Hawkins.
Great athletic skills. Good move by number 33 from Bradley. Percy Hawkins, and let me tell you, he'll have to be productive here in the next 3:28.
A lot of people in foul trouble. We'll keep an eye on it for you.
There's the free throw statistics. Bradley is state of the game at the line.
Foul in the lane.
Basketball, make a little drop pass to Mike Williams, but he continued on through with the shot. Braxick's got to go out of the ball game. That can't help. Powell with the possibility of a three-point play if he converts the free throw.
Boy, he has played well against Illinois State. There he is. Good concentration, good form. But Braxick coming right up on him.
There's a look at Braxick on the Illinois State bench. Hollifield, Sanders, and Taphorn, the forwards in the ballgame for Illinois State. Harrison starts the backcourt combination. This is Donald Powell to Bradley at the line. Won't go on the three-point play try, and it's a four-point lead for Illinois State. This is the point at which Illinois State has been able to answer the challenge. Every time Bradley got a big basket and cut it to four, they were able to take the lead back to six.
A chant of ISU from the crowd here in attendance. Large contingent from Central Illinois, and of course they're split. It's a great rivalry in Central Illinois, and I wonder who the Tulsa fans are rooting for.
Certainly one of the better, stronger rivalries in the Missouri Valley Conference. There are good ones. This is one of the best.
Harris, 10 to go now on the shot clock. Hollifield feeding inside, it won't go down low. Once again, it's up by Sanders. Hawkins claims the rebound.
He had a pretty good shot. Coach Donowell wanted a foul, but it was not called.
West for two, no. Paddle for the rebound. Powell, and he had to be fouled inside. There was enough contact on that play.
I mean, Coach Donowell is stopping down at the other end of the floor.
Jimmy West took the initiative to make it happen here.
Look at the penetration. Forces the shot just a little bit, but excellent penetration by Les. You see a lot of people in there going after the basketball. Donald Powell comes away with it, tries to take it back up and gets fouled.
Hollifield picks up his second personal foul. He's just flicked us on both teams and been over the foul limit since about the midway point of the second half. Donald Powell now can bring it to a two-point deficit if he connects right here.
Are we in for some kind of a blue ball?
We've still got 2:27 to go. Hawkins has the rebound, and Bradley's got 45 seconds on the shot clock.
Great shot by Hawkins.
Jimmy West, number 15, Crimpy at the point at the moment. Good interior feed to Williams, who is clobbered down low. Matt Taphorn will pick up the foul here.
He's trying to give defensive help from the help side.
Taphorn picks up his fourth. Mike Williams at the free throw line. 54% free throw shooter this season at the line. He has 20 points here this afternoon, and he is 5 out of 6 from the charity stripe. What a job he has done. What a tournament he's had. Sanders on the rebound. Redbirds will work the clock a bit here. Under 2 minutes to go, as you can see. Illinois State on the attack with the lead. 3-point lead for the Redbirds. Ninth-ranked Bradley on the ropes. They haven't lost since December 28th. Against Clemson at the Rainbow Classic in Hawaii. They have not lost in conference play. Starks. Sanders gets it back. The ball fired loose by Les. And a foul called by Tom O'Neill. Four fouls on Jimmy Les. He'll have to be very careful, but he knows that, and he's played with four fouls before and a lot longer than the minute and 30 seconds that's left here in this ballgame. Peterson reports on for Illinois State.
You want to talk about some big free throws?
Uh-huh. Here we go.
What did this young
first
man play with? Great
free throw line.
Did he play with great confidence?
72% free throw shooter, and he comes up off the back of the iron, and Donald Powell has it. Bradley trails by three. Minute 25 to go. Game clock roaring right of your screen. Beautiful feed, Williams! Impressively done! 1 point ball game. Illinois State trying to hang on, but Bradley storming back. The nation's longest winning streak, 21 games on the line here tonight by Bradley. Playing their stiffest rival, their arch rival, the Redbirds of Illinois State, and the Redbirds have really come up with a super effort here tonight. They still lead by a point. There's the clock lower, right-hand corner of your screen.
15 seconds on the shot clock. You're looking at the game clock there.
They're not going to get a good shot away. Tap point, it won't go. The tap won't go. Trippy has the rebound. Bradley with less than a minute to go. It's a chance for the lead bucket.
Do you take the timeout?
Jimmy Les. So Williams inside. The shot clock out of bounds by Hollifield. It'll belong to Bradley. Dipper stays up off the bench talking with Getcher on the play, and he wants a timeout. Bradley uses their second timeout of this second half. They have two remaining. That's the Bradley huddle right there. They have stormed back to within one, and they have the ball. 20 seconds to go. We'll be back.
Who's going to be at the Silver Bullet tonight? Sipping on a cold Coors Light.
Are you right?
No Irish at all.
Who's gonna come and play? Come on a Coors Light, St. Patrick's Day.
Come on, you're Irish.
Okay, I'm Irish.
That's funny, you don't look Irish.
No slowing down with a silver bullet tonight.
So look for this display with Beowulf. I'm Irish. Whatever you buy, Coors and Coors Light beer.
Leading the way.
There's a world of difference in TWA. It's the difference between getting you where you're going and leading the way.
State Farm agent Pam Dunlap talks about life insurance.
The key in life insurance is listening to the policyholder and trying to determine what that policyholder needs. Now, when a policyholder comes in this office, they don't know that they need whole life or term insurance, but they do know what they want to protect. And so it's my responsibility to sit there and let them talk and listen to them and then try to tailor our life insurance products to their needs.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm.
Here's the dunk by Mike Williams that puts Bradley within one. An excellent pass inside. He goes up with authority, obviously. You see it there. 64-63. Illinois State up by one. Bradley's basketball underneath their basket.
Illinois State hasn't scored since the 3:28 mark left to be played in the game.
Len Bertolini. Jimmy Les off the inbound. That's the game clock. Roller right of your screen. No shot clock. Maintain the winning streak.
Watch him win.
Hawkins on the draw.
Watch him win it.
You bet. 3 seconds to go. Bradley leading by a point. 10 points. Doesn't get this down away. Another miracle finish by the
Insurance in TWA. It's the difference between getting you where you're going and leading the way.
Sipping on a cold Coors Light.
Are you right?
No Irish at all.
Who's gonna come and play? Come on, the Coors Light, St. Patrick's Day.
Come on, you're Irish.
Okay, I'm Irish.
That's funny, you don't look Irish.
No slowing down for the silver bullet tonight.
So look for this display with Beowulf. I'm Irish. Wherever you buy Coors and Coors Light beer.
For the 13th time, wins by 4 points or less, and they do it in incredible fashion. Percy Hawkins on a drive down the lane.
You know, Wayne, that is the only lead that Bradley had in the entire ballgame. They played 40 minutes of basketball and finally get a one-point lead with 2 seconds left on the clock. Just an incredible finish. What a great move and a great shot by Wayne Larrabee.
By Wayne. You thought I was sleeping.
That's right. How about you picked up on that?
All right, they keep the winning streak alive. Now watch it right here. 22 wins in a row, and there goes the Hawk.
How about that? Look where he takes off. Look at the body control. Look at the way he uses the glass. Well, I tell you what, it's just exciting to see the way the basketball game was played by both basketball teams, the way it was coached by both Versace and Donewald. And, of course, the finish is just unbelievable. I mentioned it one more time. The only time they led was at the end of the game.
Well, of course, and you take a look and you talk about preparation for this ball game. Boy, Illinois State was ready, weren't they? They played so well. And Bradley kind of picked away at a 12-point deficit all the way.
Well, I felt like the man-to-man defense in the second half that Bradley played. They played more man-to-man defense in the second half than they did in the first half. I thought that that had a lot to do with throwing Illinois State out of sync. It really had an impact on them. They did go back to the 1-3-1 zone, played a little bit of 2-3 zone, but the man-to-man defense, I think, was a determining factor. You know, they don't use it much. They didn't use it much yesterday against West Texas State, but it's always effective for them, and they always have somebody there to do the big thing at the right time.
Well, Bradley now is in the championship game of the Missouri Valley Conference postseason tournament. This is only the second MVC postseason game that they have won outside of Peoria, and of course, this is the first year that the tournament has been held entirely on one site here in Tulsa. Now, Bradley will take on the winner of the upcoming game between the Drake Bulldogs and the Tulsa Golden Hurricane. That should be one heck of a game coming up, and it should be a great final, whoever advances.
Well, it'll be a great basketball game, and now that I've settled down and I'm not quite so excited, would you excuse me for trying to give Wayne Larrabee the credit for making the winning basket for Bradley? That's a good one. You guys will haunt me with that one.
Oh, you bet we will. We've got it on tape, too. We'll replay it. There are the brackets right there. Bradley advances, and they've really been pressed. West Texas State gave them all they wanted to handle on opening day yesterday, and now Bradley advances in the final seconds against Illinois State. And you could see the way Drake and Tulsa advanced yesterday. And now Drake, of course, is taking on Tulsa here tonight in the second game of the doubleheader. I do want to bring up one individual. We talk about Percy Hawkins, of course. They'll talk about that shot and the double pump in the lane and the scoop as he went to the bucket. But the guy who really kept Bradley within shouting distance as Illinois State built a 12-point lead was Mike Williams. He had 22 points and, what was it, 7 rebounds in the game.
Well, he really did do a great job at the offensive end of the floor, and not only do you have to credit Mike Williams for what he did inside with some very strong physical inside play, but you're going to have to give a lot of credit to his teammates, Wayne, because they did a good job of getting the ball to him at the right time away from the defense so that he was able to take it to the glass and use that powerful body that he has.
Great rivalry and lived up to every expectation we could have.
I'll tell you, I don't know how it could have been any better. you know, you talk about whether it's played, it doesn't matter, I guess, whether it's played in Peoria, Normal, Tulsa, or anyplace else.
All right, again, Bradley wins it by a point in the final seconds. Good night, everybody.
The Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week has been brought to you in part by State Farm. For a good price and great service on all your family insurance, check with the State Farm agent nearest you. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Coors Light, the silver...